Hey, everybody, this is Pastor Lyle. Hey, I want to talk to you today about the Word of God, Jesus Christ, you know, how he was through all of them. From Genesis to Revelations, Jesus Christ is through all these scriptures that is there. He is the Word of God. It's the power. It's what holds everything together. It's Jesus. It's God's Word of all things. Listen here what John says. This is, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So right there, John already telling us that Jesus is who he says he is. It's the most powerful thing in all of creation. It was with God in the beginning. You know, because if you go back to Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, it says, in God, right? In the beginning, God. So there's a singular. So there's only one. We know Jesus Christ. We know this is the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The three are one. So in all the creation, Jesus Christ is the Word. And God is the Word. And the Holy Spirit are all together in creation. Right? It says, now let's continue on. It says, through him all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. So John is telling us that he was there in the beginning. Even before creation even started, Jesus Christ was there. Now let's continue on. Let's go to Colossians chapter 1. And let's look a little bit more into what Paul talks about. And he's talking to the Colossians here, right? It says, the Son is the image of the invisible God. It says, the Son is the image. Remember, when God created man, he says, let's create man in our image and in our likeness. And I like to say, let us create man in our. So there's a plural there. So Jesus Christ, God is saying, hey, the Word and the Holy Spirit, let's make something in our image and in our likeness, something that'll represent us, right? You know, an invisible God, right? Let's continue on a little bit here. It says, the Son is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation. So Paul is also saying here too, so it's just confirming what John was talking about. He was there before creation of all things. It says, for in him all things were created, things in heaven and on earth. So let's go back to Genesis now, chapter 1, verse 1. It says, you know, and it talks about, and God created the heavens and the earth. So here it talks about he was the firstborn over all creation. So the Word was there. Jesus Christ was there before the creation of the earth and the heavens that talks about there in Genesis chapter 1, right? Let's continue on a little bit further there, right? This is, all things have been created through him and for him, right? Through him and for him. So the Word, Jesus Christ, was in creation. He wasn't just, didn't come into existence, you know, in the New Testament. He was there in the beginning of Genesis 1 all the way to the end of Revelations. Jesus Christ, the Word of God, is there. It's the most powerful thing. That's what gives us our strength. That's what gives us the power to overcome all things of all creation, right? Let's continue on in verse 17 in Colossians 1, verse 17. It says, he is before all things. Now, here again, Paul is confirming that Jesus Christ was before all things. So Jesus Christ was there in chapter 1, verse 1 in Genesis. So all things were created through him and for him. He is before all things, and in him all things hold together, right? He holds everything. It's the Word of God. Everything we see out here, when you're outside walking or anything, when you see the trees, the birds, when you're out fishing in the waters, everything is held together by the Word of God. Even when you look up in the stars, you're seeing God's Word at work. And it's still creating out there. Remember, because God says, laid the foundations of everything that we see. It's the Word of God. In Genesis chapter 1, you know, when it says, in the beginning, God. In the beginning, God created the heaven. So Jesus Christ was there. So why would we want to go anywhere else? Why would we want to worship the devil or anything else that has no power over the Word of God? They cannot create anything. But through Jesus Christ, the creator of all things, gives us the strength to overcome all things. The devil, to overcome all those cravings that the world gives us, you know, our sexual desires, our drinking, our drugs, our foul language, you know, our mental thoughts, you know, all can be controlled through the Word of God. We have to allow the Spirit of Jesus Christ to come inside of us. The man, the creator of all things, wants to dwell inside of us. He died on the cross for us. He shed his blood on that cross. Remember, it's the man died on the cross. It's the Word that bled for us. It's the Word that rose up from the grave on the third day. and was given a new body, a heavenly body, which is what we will receive too through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. You know, when we perish, we go in the grave, and that great day when Jesus Christ comes back for his church, which will be us, we'll have that same glorified body through Jesus Christ, the man in Genesis chapter 1. You know, I'm going to continue on a little bit more too, but I'm going to talk about how Jesus Christ is in Genesis. So just pay tuned, because I'm going to talk some more about the Word of God and how it represents man's salvation and the strength to overcome all things through Scriptures.